Hello all, welcome to CSK Technologies. In this video today we'll be learning how to make this model. It's a simple part modeling practice exercise at our institute. First, we will begin with understanding the views. This is a third angle projection. You have a front view, you have the right view, you have the left view and the top view. The reason there are two different views is because the pattern of the holes are different on this plate and different on this particular plate. There is also a top view which describes the feature which is this plate, and you also have a section view. Section is cut exactly at this location to show you how the interior features of the model would look like. Since the body is being controlled in a diametrical manner, I would like to use either a revolve or a shaft command using any CAD tool, whichever you prefer. You can try this model in any CAD tool available with you, but in this video, we will be using CATIA as the CAD tool. So let us see how to make this model using CATIA. First, let us start with the CATIA software. We are working under a part design, so we are entering into the part design. Since my body is completely a revolved body, I'll be using a shaft command. So there is a sketch option inside the shaft. Now, continuing with our sketch, we already know how the shaft command works. We can start making the profiles. The diameter for the whole body is actually 120 and the length is 200. So let me take that the length is first is 200 and the diameter. Let me extend the axis so we can give diametrical dimension. The diametrical dimension for this one is actually 120. Now, this will create a complete 360 degrees revolved body. Now, the body is not only revolved, but it also has a draft of 5 degrees. As you can see, it's a little slanted. It's slanted on both the sides with respect to the center. So, how to do that? We have a draft command in CATIA which helps you do that. First, you can select what are the faces would you require and the neutral element with respect to which you want to create a draft on both the sides. I want the 5 degree draft, so I'll be doing it on both the sides as you can see on the screen. A detailed video about drafts will be posted shortly. Please like and subscribe and click on the notification button if you want to get notified whenever we post a tutorial or a command tutorial as such. Now, continuing as we have given the draft, now there is a round of 30 as well. So let's try to take that 30 as well. This is your revolve, that is shaft and draft as well as the round. From here, we need a particular profile or a reference to make this feature. So we can take a plane at 80 and create the 60 dia to the immediate next face. So let me try to take a plane using a plane command under your references toolbar. It's up to 80. On this, I'd like to create the addition of material, which is a 60 dia. We have just seen the 60 dia. It's exactly located at the center and the diameter is supposed to be 60. The material is added up to the next surface. So I'll just give up to next so it adds properly as you can see. Now, there is a further addition on top of this, which is actually 120. It's a 120 square plate. So let's try to take that square plate on this face or on the top face or on the plane, any way you like. Since it's a square, we can just use a centered rectangle. The video about centered rectangle is already posted. You can go through with it. The length of this one is actually 120. This is 120 as well. Exit. This is added up to a certain distance, which is 15. As you can see, it's only added up to 15. You can change it here or you can double click on change it there as well. Now, continuing with making the model, we'll add these plates. Now, which is a 15 TYP. The overall diameter is 150. It's on both the sides, so we can do it on one side and mirror it onto the other side as well, since they are of the same dimensions. If they are not of the same dimensions, you have to repeat the same pad command which we are trying to do right now and add up to 15 in this direction. 15. Now you can mirror the same thing on with respect to the center. You can do that with the other side. Now, initially while making the sketch, the reason for taking symmetry is because of the 5-degree angle. Now we can also use it to mirror this, as we have just done a minute ago. Now, there is an internal cut of the body as well. So to remove it, you can use a groove command. So let's try to remove the internal cuts. You can offset from the existing edge by selecting the body. I'll keep that in a reference format. The same I can do it here as well. Now this has to be offsetted to 15. You can do it on the bottom side or on the top side, whichever you're flexible, use that. I'd like to do it at the bottom side, and I want to offset this face to 15. Same way I'd like to do this as well, to 15. Now I can join these two by simply extending them or using your trim command. Again, the video on trim is provided in the tutorial, sketcher tutorials. Now I'd like to project these edges, so I can corner them a little later. Now you can again use your trim command to do so, and same way I can do this as well. Now the exact center axis, I have it at this location, so I'll trim off whatever is not necessary for me and then keep the actual references. Now let me close the profile and start creating the internal cuts. This is my internal cut. If you want to see, you can use your dynamic sectioning to do so. I'll just select the front plane and show it to you. This is my internal cut. Now we are done with the actual main modeling. So as per the feature based modeling, we can proceed to the further operations. So let's try to do the hole operations first. There is a counter bore hole actually over here, which is a 50 dia and depth 8 and 40 through. So this is a 50 dia, the depth is 8 and the 40 is through. So let's try to do that. There is some graphic issue, so it's not showing the exact notations in the drawing. So let me try to coincide this on this, and same way coincide this on the center. I want a counter bore hole, so under types I am using a counter bore. Under this counter bore, we know that this is supposed to be of 50 and depth 8. So this is supposed to be 50 with depth of 8, and this is supposed to be up to next in the, of actually dia 40. This will be a counter bore. Now there are other holes as well, which let us continue to do that. First, let us use your hole command on the left side of my feature. That is, I'm trying to use it on the left side. So whenever I try to do this, this is a simple hole. Okay. Now, under this, it is located at 45 degrees and on 20 PCD. So let me, 120 PCD. Now let me try to position the sketch and use my bisecting line. Again, bisecting line tutorials is already given in your sketcher playlist. You can go and look through with that. Now we have a 120 dia as well. With respect to the center, I'd like to give the 120 dia. Now this should be on 45 exactly. The diameter of the hole is 6. Dia 10, and there are 6 copies, so I'll give dia 10 up to next and say I want 6 copies. To give 6 copies, we already know we can use a simple axis pattern, so let us try to do that circular pattern. We require complete crown, we need 6 copies. With respect to the difference element of this body, or you can give the axis as well. Once you say okay, it tries to drill the 6 ones. The same way we can do it on the right side as well. For instance, I am again taking the hole command on this face. Now, under that, I have it exactly at this location, as you can see on 120 PCD dia 14. So while making the positioning, it has to be exactly at the center, but it has to lie on 120 PCD. So let me try to take that 120 PCD now. It will lie on that, and the dia for this is actually 14. So it will take up to 14. Again, the same way you can create a circular pattern. We need 6 of them with particular reference, and then you can say okay, it creates these holes. There are 4 more holes located exactly at the top, as you can see at 85 distance. So let me try to take that at 85 distance first. I'll keep a point, mirror it onto the opposite side. Again, I'm selecting both of them. I'd like to mirror it onto the opposite side. Now I'll give 85 as the distance between both of them. This is supposed to be 85. And this is supposed to be 85. On this, there's a hole with exactly located at the point. Let me try to select the point first. It will be a little more easier for me. And then the face. Now, on this, there is another one which is 12 through. The hole is 12 through. So, I'll just give it 12 and give OK. Now, I can directly use a point pattern or a user pattern and select the instances. It auto does the points for us. Last but not the least, they are rounds. There are 25 rounds, so let's try to give that. This is from this corner is actually 25. This is supposed to be 25. And there are other rounds as well, which is of 2, is located at this as well as that. So let's try to do that too. This is first, this is second, and I have it at this location as well. This is just 2. This is your final model of how you use how do you make a model using draft, as well as draft using neutral element and using your shaft. You can change the two different shading locations, it will look a little better. If you have any queries, please feel free to contact us for any training purposes or queries. We also do offer job placements if you are interested. The details are given in the description below. Thank you.